would help if we could decide here and now on your name.
My name?
Yes, ma'am. Your regnal name. That is the name you'll take as queen. Your father took George. Obviously, his name was Albert. Your uncle took Edward. Of course, his name was David.
Let's not overcomplicate matters unnecessarily. My name is Elizabeth.
And long live Queen Elizabeth.
Dearest Lilibet, I know how you loved your papa, my son, and I know you will be as devastated as I am by this loss. But you must put those sentiments to one side now, for duty calls.
When the death of the king was announced to us yesterday morning, there struck a deep and somber note in our lives. The late king, who assumed the heavy burden of the crown when he succeeded his brother, lived through every minute of this struggle.
I understand the agony you feel, and I am here to tell you it will never leave you.
The grief for your father's death will be felt far and wide. Your people will need your strength and leadership. The less you do, the less you say, or agree, or smile,
or think, or feel, or breathe, or exist,
the better.
But where does that leave me? I am aware that I'm surrounded by people who feel that they could do the job better. Strong people with powerful characters. More natural leaders, perhaps better suited to leading from the front, making a mark. But for better or worse, the crown has landed on my head. Don't you get sick of it all?
And lonely.
I do. Which is why it's so important to have the right person by your side.
What kind of marriage is this? What kind of family? You've taken my career from me, you've taken my home, you've taken my name. I thought we were in this together.
Times are changing. Country is changing.
So it goes. It stings and bites we suffer as it slips away. Bit by bit, piece by piece.
And so it goes through George V to Queen Victoria and back, an uninterrupted line, stolid, turgid dreariness.
Culminating in me. The history of the monarchy in this country is a one-way street of humiliation, sacrifices and concessions in order to survive. We go from ruling to reigning to...
to what?
To being nothing at all. Marionettes.
Alongside that dull, dutiful, reliable, heroic strain runs another. The dazzling, the brilliant, the individualistic, and the dangerous. So, for every Victoria, you get an Edward VII. For every George V, you get a Prince Eddie. For every George VI, you get an Edward VIII. For every Lilibet, you get a Margaret.
Ask yourself, in the time I've been on the throne, what have I actually achieved? This country was still great when I came to the throne, and now look. All that's happened on my watch is the place has fallen apart.
It's only fallen apart if we say it has. There's a thing about the monarchy. We paper over the cracks. And if what we do is loud, grand, confident enough, no one will notice. All around us it's falling apart. That's the point of us. Not us. You. You cannot flinch.
Must I do that alone?
There is only one queen.
And on days like today, in places like this, you get a glimpse of what it all might have been like, the unlived life. And how much happier it might have made me. Which meant that first my father, and then I, had to do a job we were never meant to do.
Well, you've managed to make it look like the other thing is the only thing you were ever meant to do.
God.